Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Futties Batch 2, Best of Re-Release 2, whatever you want to call it, dropped yesterday. The content was insane. The market crash was insane as well, but it was expected, right? I want to talk about what happened yesterday and what could continue to happen into the Saturday of Futties. Big SBCs, nice objectives, new season content as well, and of course, all the craziness happening on the market with TOTS cards being re-released back into packs. Now again, you saw some insane price drops yesterday, but also some price rebounds as well. But again, we knew these price drops were coming. It was just a matter of time before they came. Check out this Mr. Sancho card who was 700 and wow, that's a coin transfer. But this card was 750,000 coins earlier yesterday. He is now down at like 350,000 coins. And he's still in packs for another 2 weeks. Again, it is confirmed as well that Batch 2, these TOTS cards, mostly TOTS cards in Batch 2, are going to be out in packs for 2 weeks. So let's talk about these cards a little bit, right? Futties Batch 2, this is the spreadsheet, the Foot Economist spreadsheet, right? And basically, there's 150 cards that are in packs. Last Batch 1, the last time there were special cards in packs, there was 100. Now we have 150. Maybe Batch 3 will be 200, who knows? But basically, it's some of the biggest names in Team of the Season. 104 of the 150 cards that are in packs are TOTS items. So we have a lot of Team of the Season cards that are in packs. And you have some future stars. If you tried investing for Batch 1 cards that were going out of packs, EA screwed people over today on a few of those cards. Ansu Fati re-released, Saka, Bergwijn, Foot Birthday, Ferlan Mendy was re-released back into packs. So some of those cards actually didn't get a quote-unquote break and allow them to rise out of packs because they were re-released. But Future Stars, Foot Birthdays, a couple Team of the Weeks, and then mostly Team of the Seasons that were re-released back into packs today, which is exactly what we were expecting. So again, let's take a look at some of these market movements, right? Because you know, we made some coins today. We'll talk about that. But these prices were mental, right? Goretzka was 800K. He went down to 350. Now, you didn't see as crazy amount of a rise on some of these cards. Now, the big top tier cards like Neymar, Ronaldo, and Mbappe, those both are all three continued to go down further. Right now, Neymar is 1.9 million coins. 1.99. Look at all these first owner fresh ones on the market. It's crazy. With the 88 plus star pack that we had yesterday, which is a 95,000 coin pack, according to EA Sports. And then just the amount of coins that are going to be drained off the market in the next couple of days as well, with upgrade packs coming, an 85 times 10 SBC that is cracked, and a Futties player pick for Batch 2, just a ton of panic today. Now, there also were some opportunities to make coins, right? We found some of the rare Team of the Season items that dropped off. We knew during that first 10 to 30 minutes window was going to be an opportunity to buy some cards. I bought these Insignias. I think one of them was at like 70K. One was like 65. Sold them at 90. This Rashford was a break even. There was some over-investing, and it wasn't as profitable on all cards as Batch 1 the first day was, but there's a ton of profit, right? Alibas, I bought these at 105 and 107. Bought this Barnes at 59K. And then some of the other stuff that actually did go out of packs, I bought this at 250. I bought this at 180. And some of these other Premier League cards, I bought this at 238K. I bought some Calvin Phillips at 130. He's actually back down a little bit right now. But again, the biggest part about the content yesterday was the just tradable cards that were put back into packs. Now, I don't know if I can go into FootDraft at the moment. I have one made. So let me see if I can go into the store through single player draft really quick. Let me go to the store this way. And again, we had some interesting preview packs that were released. We expected, I have one here to open myself. But we expected this 88 plus star rare mega preview, which I got a TOTS player from. But again, these are the preview packs that we were expecting to see today, and that's why we saw so much supply on the market, along with people that had saved up packs as well. Because like myself, people didn't open packs for like the whole last week because they were tired of the items that were in packs. Two Higuains, what are the odds of that? Two different 25K packs. Unbelievably, EA Sports, let's go. Come on, mix it up. Anyways, this pack goes away today on Saturday, and so does this one. So I would expect to see a new sort of preview pack added into the game today. I've got a couple random packs still here from doing SBCs, but that's the next part that I want to actually talk about, SBCs. We know the market crashed. We knew that was going to be coming. And actually, before we get to SBCs, let's talk about some of these cards a little bit more and look at some graphs too, because of course, you had these cards drop down insane amounts yesterday. There was panic selling beforehand, and we knew there was going to be a little bit of a rebound on some of these really top tier cards. Check out CR7, right? He was down at 1.37. He went into the 1.2s during that first hour of panic and then rebounded back up to where he is right now, 1.4. Now, with these cards in packs, again, for 2 weeks, just like we saw with the Team of the Year Ronaldo, and if we have the 99 Ronaldo coming out in 2 weeks from now with Batch 3, the Team of the Year, the Team of the Season, all of this stuff is going to go lower over the next 2 weeks, especially because of how people are turning in coins and doing SBCs in the state of this game at the moment. So again, yes, price has dropped off a ton, but I would expect a lot of the stuff to drop a little bit lower out of the weekend league, right? I mean, this De Jong was 380K. He went down to 270s, kind of rebounded back up to 300. There was plenty of those kind of rebounds. Ben Yedder was 170. He's now 222. Let me look for another good one. Bruno was like 540. He's now 600. I think even Luke Shaw was like 30K. Now he's 45. Rashford was overinvested, right? So he went from like 530K to 590, and now he's back down. And you're seeing a lot of that too, right? I think Joao Cancelo was somebody who got to like 75,000 coins, went all the way up to like 100K, and is now kind of back down. Harvey Barnes, who I sold at 80K earlier today, went from 60K to like 85 to 90, back down to 67. And again, I see a lot of this stuff dropping off, especially as we continue out of the weekend league, and specifically the Premier League cards. I bought a Son from my weekend league team at 220K. He went all the way up to 260 on a rebound and is now dropping back down again because of A, people finishing their Spurs, not Spurs, but their Premier League weekend leagues and the supply still coming in. Yeah, down to 220. It doesn't even show that he went back up to 260, but he did. There was a lot of those fluctuations in that first 30 minutes to an hour where I think people heard what we had talked about and expected to see some of that rebound faster than it actually happened. So we had a combination of people that were investing in some of these TOTS cards to make a quick buck, right? To make a quick flip out of it. And then you also had some people that were buying the cards back purely for their teams. And I think that the combination of a lot of buying all at the same time caused that inflation and caused those cards to go up. But I think that's going to come crashing down again, especially on Premier League cards specifically out of this weekend. Like, that's why I'm 100% going to sell my Son card, even though I bought it for the team. I'm going to play a few games tonight, probably try to cash this out. I mean, if he's 230, 240, probably going to take my money, which would be like a tax break even, buying it at 220, and just kind of get out of it, right? Because I really feel like a lot of this stuff is going to go lower as we drop out of the weekend league and have more supply. Now, again, let's talk about the content that happened yesterday too, because I think the insane content is going to continue to affect this market. This 85 times 10 repeatable SBC, this is insane. The people, the cards, and the packs that people are getting from this are absolutely incredible, right? And I think the price of this SBC has gone up a little bit, 204,000 coins. But now since all the packs have like TOTS players in there, it's very easy to get Team of the Season items to do an 82 and an 85 rated squad. And this SBC alone, alongside the new Footies player pick, which is three squads, 82, 80, and a rare gold squad. So you're turning in 33 players, but it's just very, very easy to do. All of the low rated fodder on the market absolutely went flying. 81s, 82s, and 83s went even higher yesterday purely because of how hyped these player picks, these casinos, and the upgrade SBCs are, right? Take a look at the index 82, 364 points all the way up to 500 points on the index. 82s are like 4,000, 5,000 coins for some 82 rated cards. And as those continue to go up, this other stuff is going to go up too. 84s are up a little bit. I mean, it's just crazy how expensive some of this lower tier fodder is, because that's how they've kind of molded the SBC requirements for a lot of these squads, which makes things very interesting. Now, also coming out later this week, Sunday is going to be a huge, huge day. Sunday is going to be insane because that means upgrade packs, right? And if they give us decent upgrade packs, the amount of grindability and craftability you're going to be able to have with these Footies player picks and with the 85 times 10 SBCs is going to be unreal. It's just going to be nonstop, insane, 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 high amounts of, you know, upgrade packs you're going to be able to do, rinsing into this, rinsing into the player pick to get TOTS cards and hopefully hit some big time items. Now, what this 85 times 10 is, I'm seeing people opening these and getting 4+, sometimes like 6 or 7 TOTS cards in the same pack. And what that's really going to make easy is crafting icon moments player SBCs. If you want to do Maradona, if you want to do Hullet, if you haven't started on one of these SBCs that requires so many high rated cards, to be honest, if you have coins and you want to put in an upgrade grind, doing Ronaldinho and Hullet over the next 2 weeks or the week, or at least the next 4 days while this is out with player picks, if they release this 85 plus times 10, you're going to have 3 days to do it with upgrade packs out. I guess not the next 2 weeks unless they revamp this, but these 85 times 10 are going to be so popular for crafting those icon SBCs just because you're getting so many above 90 rated cards from each of those packs, which is incredible. So again, with all the stuff that there is in packs, people say FIFA is dead right now, man. I mean, it's just dead on the market, right? Because all these cards are so cheap and everybody's packing them left, right, and center, and it's so easy to get them, but that's fun. That's how it should be at this stage of the year. So that SBC upgrade pack grind is the most insane part about the content yesterday. Now let's talk about players. We had one of the best ever SBCs in terms of a player upgrade yesterday as well. This 97 Dybala, who I loved his moments card, almost everybody loved his moments card earlier this year. He got not only a skill move and a weak foot boost, 5-star skills, 4-star weak foot, he got a work rate boost as well from medium to high medium. And if you take a look at this guy's attributes, if you put a hawk chemistry style on this card, he literally has perfect pace, perfect shooting, almost perfect passing except for long pass, I think, and like perfect dribbling. It's unbelievable how good this card looks. 5-star skills, 4-star weak foot. This dude's going to be a menace. And, you know, it's maybe pushing us the start of pushing us towards a Serie A week. We had a Serie A card and objectives as well. But this Dybala SBC, if you're trying to craft, I know it's 10 squads. It's kind of like Zaha, in all honesty. But, you know, this is a card that's kind of worth the grind. It's kind of worth it. The 10 squads thing, again, I don't like just because it seems like so much. It seems like such a daunting task and so many cards to turn in. But 500K for that card is stupid unreal. So I think that's an insane SBC. GG's to EA on that one. We also had the Dan James 5-star skill upgrade SBC. High work rates. I think this one's a lot cheaper. It's coming in at like 150K, I believe. Let's actually check out and see how people are receiving these. 1,000 thumbs up for Dan James, which is pretty good, right? That's a good SBC. And then Dybala has got 2,600 thumbs up. I think people are all over this, man. All over this Dybala SBC. Watch out for your Serie A links, your Juve/Piemonte Calcio links as well. And even this Pinamonti card, which is from Objectives. Not the most liked card, but again, this was the winning item from the team events, right? And that's one thing I want to talk about right now too, are the team events. There was a new one yesterday. I clicked on the wrong thing. Sorry, right there. Objectives. If you go all the way over to the left for teams, you have to choose between Jordan Amavi and then Jason Denayer. And then it'll take you into your objectives. I chose Denayer, and you can go in here and you can complete these objectives to kind of, I guess, vote for that card. So when this ends, basically in 2 weeks, we will either get a Futties Jason Denayer or Futties Jordan Amavi card via objective like we had this Pinamonti. Now today on Saturday, I would expect to see a Futties favorite card as a part of objectives as well. I would expect another objective player today, I do think. I doubt it would be in milestones because they can put all this back in under the objective tab again, since the milestone stuff is more like longer term and stuff that had to go past the new season, which of course, the new season is just really filler content. Again, I love the Vertonghen because I'm, of course, a Spurs fan. Of course, the Nkudu. But for a lot of you guys, probably the Sanchiampong is going to be the way to go. 5'6", 4-star, 4-star, level 15. It's basically just 90 rated fodder for all three of these guys. TBH. And then level 30, if you're going to be grinding all the way to there, Rodrigo, Kula Daddy, and Julian Brandt with arguably one of the most laughable dynamic images of all time. It looks good with the yellow on the card as well. That's a pretty good looking dynamic image, like the color combo. But anyways, kind of a funny dynamic from Brandt, Koulibaly, of course, and Rodrigo. So level 30 cards, if you're going to get there, those are your options. But again, it's all about the SBC content. It really is, because right now what everybody's doing is they're doing these 85 times 10 to either craft SBCs, or they're doing these Futties player picks to try to snag themselves one of the big guys that are in packs, right? Tots, Neymar, Mbappe, Ronaldo, Varane, Ben Yedder, Sancho, Messi, right? I mean, it's going to be really, really fun this week, I think, to craft these squads, especially when the upgrade packs come out. And it's just quote unquote cheap, right? It's not 100% cheap right now because, of course, you know, you have those low rated cards that are so much. The Footies player pick costs 90,000 coins to do, which technically, if you think about it, I did one of those today and I packed Suarez. How much is Suarez on the market? He's probably like 100K. 68K, so he's not even 100K. So I packed Suarez, right? I didn't even make my money back, quote unquote, from this Footies player pick. But 90,000 coins, there's a ton of potential. People are going to be hammering those. And the 85 times 10 repeatable as well. 200K to technically get that done from scratch. But just the amount of fodder that you get from it. And if you're doing upgrade packs at that same time to craft that SBC, is going to be mental. So again, let's talk about today on Saturday though. What's going to happen content wise? I would expect another Footies favorite, probably still January, maybe another January Footies favorite. Maybe one of the other SBCs that they released around Team of the Year time that was very popular. People are shouting out potentially like a Kleiber. That was a card, I think that came out in December actually. And maybe since we skipped over December and we've gone to January with Dybala, they won't go back and do a Kleiber, but we'll have to see what they do. But I do expect another Footies favorite via SBC today, some sort of upgrade pack, and then probably a new objective. It should be a decent day of content today on Saturday, and good luck to all you guys grinding the weekend league. This is the squad that I'm about to start with. I bought the Sun and I bought the Ndombele today. Again, I'm probably going to play some games tonight and then cash them out and take my money, and then when I play tomorrow, just hop on and buy them and use them, because again, it is end game, yes, but I want to try to be fiscally responsible as possible. So again, there was a lot of panic selling yesterday, right? I mean, there was panic selling on the cards that didn't go, that went back out of packs from being in packs from batch one. Of course, the massive panic selling on those cards. But really, really, really watch the fluctuations on these summer stars and stuff that are out of packs, right? If you're really trying to trade, in packs is going to be great for fluctuations as well. But really watch the out of pack stuff too, like some of these summer stars. Sterling was like 850K. He rebounded back up and now he's kind of back down again, right? So you're going to see continual movement on a lot of these items as people are playing FIFA, of course, but they know that the cards that are in packs right now necessarily aren't the absolute best, right? Tots cards, yeah, they're good, but we also have PTG and Summer Stars. So again, this week just seems really fun. And yesterday was really, really fun with the prices dropping as well. It just makes all these cards so much more attainable to people in this game that maybe were not able to get them before. Messi's 800,000 coins, man. I mean, this dude, look at the big drop off there on that Messi card. It's insane. So that was the name of the game yesterday, right? Insane price drop offs, probably not as insane of drop offs coming today, but more of the same prices kind of leaking downwards is the word that I describe it with as we head out of the weekend league and as people do more 85 times 10 packs, Footies player picks, and the gamble casino SBCs, if you will. But I'm hoping for more player objectives and SBCs today, more fun market movements. I will be streaming it all live down on Twitch, link in the description if you want to get involved and come through when we are live streaming. So that's the video for today, boys. But again, big market crash. It was very fun to trade, to watch the cards drop. And if you got ahead and sold your cards ahead of time, you were very happy with that outcome because now they're just a lot cheaper to go out and buy for your team, kind of like what I did with the Ronaldo situation. So if you did enjoy it, smash a thumbs up on it, comment down below if you have any questions, and subscribe if you're new. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace out.